channel. My name is Angel, if you are new here, and welcome back to another Fragrance Friday video. You guys, I am super excited, and you guys already know what time it is. So we're going to be talking about some fragrances in today's video, of course, and today we're going to be focusing on more like floral and fruity fragrances. So if you would like to see some of my favorites or some that I have been using recently, then just keep on watching. So starting off with number one, the first fragrance that I have to show you guys is the YSL Mon Petit. This is the Eau de Parfum, and I believe I have this is just the 1 fluid ounce bottle, you guys. It's a lot of juice in here to be 1 fluid ounce. Oh my goodness. So this perfume will definitely be considered a more floral and fruity fragrance. It definitely has some florals in it, and it also has some of those fruity notes. This fragrance is literally loaded with so many notes and some of my favorite notes. It has jasmine in it, it has patchouli, it has orange blossom, it has vanilla, it has everything. White musk. Like, this is well done, you guys. It is so well done. It smells so good. And some of the fruity notes that it has that I definitely pick up are the strawberry and the raspberry. This fragrance, you guys, is just very, very classy. It's very classic. You can wear this one on a date night. You can wear this one to work. You can wear this for girls' night out. Like, this perfume serves so many different purposes, you guys, especially for the springtime. I feel like I cannot stop smelling this fragrance, you guys. When I wear this one for date night with babe, I get so many compliments from him, you guys. Like, this one, and it lasts a really, really nice time. I would say I get to maybe about 6 to 7 hours out of it. It's not a beast mode fragrance, so if you definitely want compliments for something like that, you definitely want to make sure you take this one with you so that you can respray. But girl, this smells so, so good. Definitely pick up this one. I think all of their flankers are really good as well. I have one of their flankers. I can't remember which one it is, but this is just the original, and this one smells so, so good. I can't even talk today. I can never talk. How about that? And it only happens when I get on camera. It never happens when I'm off camera, y'all. The next fragrance I have to mention is Chloe by Chloe. This is very nice, you guys. I would definitely consider this fragrance more of a floral. It definitely has some rose in it. It has peony in it, some freesia in it. Ooh, this smells so good. I definitely can pick up on the rose in this scent, as well as the peony. So if you're not really into florals, or you don't like roses or peonies, any type of flower, this won't be for you. But I definitely love flowers. Y'all know how much I love roses. So this one just smells so, so good. It's so well done. I feel like this can be worn in multiple places as well, although I will say be careful in the workplace, especially because it is springtime and people allergies are starting to kick up and mess up a little bit, like me, myself. So yeah, be careful with this, because like that rose in it and that flower in it, that floralness that it has to it, definitely can cause maybe some irritation to your coworker. So, you know, this one is sexy for like brunch with the girls. I wouldn't really wear this one at night because it's just so fresh, it's just so floral and so feminine. I would more so stick to this one as far as wearing this one during the daytime, like I was saying, for brunch or something like that. This is the 1.7. This bottle is really nice too. If you are familiar with Chloe, then you know sometimes their bottles tarnish. I can just normally apply like a little alcohol or something to it, and it'll just kind of get rid of that. But that's the only thing I hate about this bottle, is that it tarnishes. But if you have any tips to keep my bottles from tarnishing, comment down below and let me know. But the packaging on this is really nice. It looks like a very rosy type of floral perfume. It just smells really, really classy. Very classy. This is also something that I will wear to a wedding, some type of daytime event, or those sorts of things. As far as the longevity on this one, I would say I maybe get about, I would say maybe about a good 5 to 6 hours. It lasts a pretty decent time. Or maybe, you know what, I may even able to get maybe like 7 hours out of this. So let's just go with 7. I'm able to get maybe about 7 hours out of this. I do kind of like get whiffs of it throughout the day. So it's not like super like rosy, like in your face, if you're not really into florals. But I definitely got whiffs of myself from wearing it throughout the day. This perfume also have amber in it. It's one of the base notes. And I definitely can say that this is one of the fragrances that make me very happy, because I love roses. I love the smell of flowers. Just not during this season, but this perfume doesn't bother me or anything like that, but it definitely is one of the more happier pick-me-up scents just because I like roses in general. And then the next two fragrances I have are from Dossier. So thank you to my friends over at Dossier for sending me over some more fragrances to try out this month. So Floriental Coconut is basically an inspired scent by Tom Ford Soleil Blanc. Basically, it is a coconut balm. If I can just describe this perfume in one word, it is just a coconut balm. It smells so freaking good. This is something you want to wear on the beach. This is something you want to wear near water. Something you want to wear during the spring and summer months. It definitely gives me like a private island, a deserted island type of vibe. Like, this, it smells so good. And the top notes on this is cardamom, pistachio, bergamot. The middle notes are ylang ylang, tuberose, jasmine. Y'all know jasmine is my favorite. Base notes are cedarwood, amber, benzoin, and coconut. Y'all, girl, how much is this? I think it's like $39.99. I love Dossier, you guys. Their fragrances are super duper affordable. Their fragrances range from $29 to about $49. I think that's like the more pricier fragrances that they have. But most of them range from about $29 to $39, if I'm not mistaken. And I also wanted to mention the perfumes that I just mentioned, you guys. The Chloe by Chloe, as well as the Mon Peri by YSL. Both of these fragrances, I know the Chloe by Chloe is on their website, a fraction of the cost. So I'm not sure how much I pay for this Chloe. I think it may be about $80 or $100. But you can get Chloe by Chloe for under $39, you guys. So if you're not into splurging on perfumes, or you want to just kind of like try some things out because you're not sure what you really like, especially because everything, some stores have opened and stuff like that, but not everywhere has opened, or depending on where, upon where you live. But if you want to try these out, I would definitely check out Dossier, a more affordable option. This one is so good, the Floriental Coconut. At first, I didn't know how I feel about this, especially just the Tom Ford private label fragrances in general. But this smells so good, you guys. Y'all, Dossier, you cannot beat this. They have some iconic scents. Designer inspired, luxury inspired, for a fraction of the cost. So be sure to check them out. My coupon code and all the information will be linked down in my description bar below, so check it out. Back to this perfume. So this has 18% concentration, and they also send you this card with everything on it. It tells you who it's inspired by, the notes, the concentration. Dossier is the business, y'all. Like, if you have not tried Dossier, what you doing? What you doing watching these Fragrance Fridays videos if you not tried out Dossier? Pause this video, go to their website, check them out, and come on back, sis. I just get so passionate and so excited when I talk about fragrance, you guys, because I talk so fast. Oh my gosh. Because I just love to smell good. Like, I love to smell good. And I didn't realize like how many compliments I was getting like from people until I really got into a perfume. And I was like, oh my gosh, like, everybody is always saying I smell good. I smell so good and so yummy. Ooh. And I just love that. That's definitely a good feeling. Everybody wants to smell good, I would hope. So the next fragrance I have to mention is by Dossier, of course. And this is their Floral Pink Pepper. This fragrance is actually inspired by their Miss Dior Cherie, the 2017 version. I actually personally didn't get a chance to smell that version because I wasn't into perfume at the time. But I love all of Miss Dior's. I love the original. I love the Absolutely Blooming. I love the Roses. Like, I love all of them. So the top notes for this one is bergamot, lychee, orange. Middle notes are rose, jasmine, pink pepper. And the base notes are patchouli, bun, woods, and vanilla. This smells so good. I love it. It lasts a really long time. And I can honestly say, this perfume projects a really good, decent amount of time, and it also just projects in general. I would have to say this is one of the most longest wearing fragrances that I have from Dossier. And Dossier does provide 50 milliliter bottles, and this is just a 1.7 ounce bottle. Like I said, everything will be linked down in my description bar below. I hope you guys enjoyed this Fragrance Friday and check out some of these perfumes that I mentioned in today's video. They also have colognes for men as well, so be sure to check them out for your boo, your bae, your hubby, your man. I'll leave everything linked down below. Thank y'all so much for watching another Fragrance Friday video with me. And if you guys enjoy these videos, as always, go ahead and give me a big thumbs up and make sure you hit that subscribe button and that notification bell so you'll be notified every time I upload a Fragrance Friday video. Until next time, you guys, be blessed, stay safe. I love y'all so much. Bye.